Last week, our Every Nation Apostolic Council gathered in Manila for our annual face-to-face meeting. Our Apostolic Council includes senior leaders from all over the world who provide spiritual, strategic, and apostolic leadership for our family of churches that now includes churches and campus ministries in over 80 nations. In our first meeting, I reminded the Apostolic Council members that we're an Apostolic Council, not a Council of Apostles. A Council of Apostles would mean that every member is an apostle. On the contrary, we intentionally put together a global governing body for every nation that includes not just apostles, but also prophets, evangelists, shepherds, and teachers. According to Ephesians 4, all five of these leadership gifts are essential for maturity and unity in the church. The result is an equipped and empowered people who are on mission with God. While not everyone on our Apostolic Council is an apostle, we expect everyone to be and to think apostolically. Just as a leader can be pastoral and not be a pastor, or prophetic and not be a prophet, and evangelistic and not be an evangelist, a leader can be apostolic and not be an apostle. In terms of understanding the function, the ick is the most important part of the Apostolic Council. So when we say apostolic or apostolic ministry, what do we actually mean? Paul uses the phrase apostolic ministry in Galatians chapter 2. Verses 7 through 10, he says this, "When they saw that I had been entrusted with the gospel to the uncircumcised, just as Peter had been entrusted with the gospel to the circumcised, for he who worked through Peter for his apostolic ministry to the circumcised worked also through me for mine to the Gentiles. And when James and Cephas and John, who seemed to be pillars, perceived the grace that was given to me, they gave the right hand of fellowship to Barnabas and me, that we should go to the Gentiles and they to the circumcised. Only they asked us to remember the poor, the very thing I was eager to do." Now, this text, while it says a lot about apostolic ministry, I only have time in this 5-minute leadership podcast to focus on three of the key ideas that describe apostolic ministry. First, apostolic ministry is gospel-centered. In verse 7, Paul speaks of his apostolic ministry to the Gentiles and Peter's apostolic ministry to the Jews in the context of the gospel. He says, "When they saw that I had been entrusted with the gospel to the uncircumcised." And he goes on to say that Peter had been entrusted with the gospel to the circumcised. So we see apostolic ministry is a gospel trust. If it doesn't include the gospel, it's not apostolic. Second, we see apostolic ministry is grace-filled. Verse 9 says, "When James and Cephas and John," these are the great leaders in the church, it says, "when they perceived the grace," that's the phrase, "perceived the grace that was given me, they gave the right hand of fellowship to Barnabas and me." So they saw grace. If it is not grace-filled and grace-powered and grace-motivated, it's not truly apostolic. Third, apostolic ministry is people-focused. It's clear in Galatians 2 that Paul's apostolic ministry focused on a people group, the Gentiles, and Peter's apostolic ministry focused on the people of the Jews. Paul didn't exclusively minister to Gentiles, and Peter didn't exclusively minister to Jews, but their apostolic ministry was definitely focused on a particular people. In the same way, God gave Hudson Taylor an apostolic ministry to Chinese people. Adoniram Judson had an apostolic ministry to the Burmese people. YWAM has an apostolic ministry to the poor in many nations. Frontiers has an apostolic ministry to Muslims in some of the most restricted areas of the world. Apostolic ministry is not for all people everywhere, but it is typically focused on a particular people group. During our Apostolic Council meeting, we all recognize that we're called to every nation in our generation, but we also recognize that we're called to every campus in every nation. We're not the only ones called to the campuses of the world, but we are called and graced by God to reach college and university students. That's part of our apostolic ministry. We're not only called to students, but we do believe that one day we will give an account to God for the campuses in our cities and in our nations. May the gospel be central and grace be abundant as you carry out your apostolic ministry to the next generation of leaders who are studying on the campuses in your community.